So class 9, as we have studied about the poem No Men Are Foreign yesterday. So what the poem No Men Are Foreign is all about? The poem No Men Are Foreign is about universal brotherhood. The poet James Pilcher, he is delivering us the message. It is only we human beings who have created these boundaries. We human beings have created different kind of territories, but actually, what is the use of creating these boundaries and these territories? There is not at all any use of creating these boundaries and territories, because these boundaries and territories, they are meant only for us only. Actually, nature is providing all the same bounties. Okay, nature is providing everything to every person in the world in the same manner. It is not at all discriminating. If nature is not discriminating, then these boundaries which we are making, they are futile. They are useless in nature. There is no need of creating these boundaries. And moreover, the poet is also saying about, you can say, the poet is also saying about, the poet is also saying about, you can say, uniforms. Okay, so he has talked about uniforms, that people like, or people like to wear uniforms, or different countries have different uniforms for their soldiers. But actually, are these uniforms they serving the purpose? No, these uniforms are not serving the purpose of it, right? Okay, and it is because of this reason that it is not serving the, you can see, it is not serving the purpose. So because of this reason that they are ironical in nature. Okay, right? So they are quite ironical in nature. Okay, so just a moment, please. I'm pausing here. So we have talked about uniforms, that uniforms are also ironical in nature. How they are ironical? Because the purpose they are serving is not at all fulfilled. So this is the reason why that uniforms are ironical in nature. So till here, any doubt to any child? It's clear? Right? So coming up to the next para, okay, in the poem, it is, they too aware of sun, air, and water, and are fed by peaceful harvest, by wars, long winter starved. Now understand the meaning of these two lines very clearly. They too aware of sun, air, and water. It means that nature is also providing them equal bounty. Nature is not at all discriminating. They too aware of these resources of nature, provided by nature, that nature is providing light to them equally, air as well as water. Then if nature is not discriminating, why we are discriminating in the name of boundaries, in the name of territories? The poet is saying, see here, and are fed by peaceful harvest. Peaceful harvest. Now, peaceful harvest. What does peaceful harvest mean? First of all, here, peaceful harvest, this is an example of transferred epithet. Note down in your books, please, that transferred epithet is, sorry, that peaceful harvest is an example of transferred epithet. How it is an example of transferred epithet? Okay, so how it is an example of transferred epithet? I told you that transferred epithet, it is, you can say, it is used with these of, you can say, the other adjective, and ultimately it is, you can say, transferring its meaning to that of another one. Okay, right? Transferred epithet means it is an adjective. You see here, peaceful adjective is used with harvest, but this peaceful, it is not, you can say, allocating the meaning to this, you can say, harvest. Actually, it is signifying something else. It means that its meaning, its function is transferred to something else, right? So this is the reason why it is called as peaceful harvest. So what it means, that are fed by peaceful harvest. Fed by peaceful harvest means that, yes, that when there is peace, people have a peaceful life, they will harvest rich crops, they will harvest to rich yield and their lives are happy. This is the meaning. Okay, they are fed by peaceful harvest. It means that they get everything or their life is peaceful. It is quite at peace and they are always harvesting rich yield because of, you can say, peaceful atmosphere that is prevalent around. People are no longer need to, you can say, suffer. They are happy, they are enjoying, and ultimately they get, they get food according to their heart's content. There is not any kind of shortage of food. There is not any kind of, you can say, scarcity of food. And everything is fulfilled. Every wish is fulfilled when the person is living a life, a happier one. And which is always, when a happier life is lived, it is always in the absence of war. Understood the meaning of peaceful harvest? Right? And the winter and the war's long winter starve. Winter starve is again an example of transferred epithet. Because winter starved. Here see, winter and starved, these meanings, they are not attributed actually here that the winter is starved, but actually what it means the long lasting and the after effects of war. It is explained here. Okay, that the war. Okay, you know what is the effect of war? It is death, destruction, loss of life, loss of relations. People, they used to suffer a lot. They have to face many kind of problems. And they take many years in order to come out of these kind of problems. So this is what the poet is saying here, that the effects of the war, they are very long. They last for a much long time. Okay, people, they have to suffer for a long, long time there. And ultimately what happens, long winter, they have to face the after effects of war for such a long time that it will take number of years to make their lives come on a, you can say, come in a proper balance. Right? So it means that the war, long winter starve. It means that people, they live a life of starvation. They live a life of, you can say, scarcity. Okay, so the effects of war, it is very, very long, and people, they have to suffer a lot because of this war. That's clear? All the students, please make me clear. It's clear to you all? Yes, right, it's fine. Right, so next afterwards, These hands are ours, as in their lines we read. Yes, so what is the meaning? It means these hands are ours. Means we have similar type of hands. There is same type of physiognomy between us and the people of the other countries. We cannot say that we are separate from them. Okay, we can't say that we are separated from them. Their hands are ours means we have the similar type of hands like they have, and there is not much difference in the type of hands in the physiognomy. We have five fingers, they also have five fingers. The same process of blood circulation is being followed. Okay, so and in lines we read, and in lines means that we put hard labor. Okay, and ultimately they also have their hard labor written in their hands, and they ultimately used to work hard in order to get the result. A labor not different from our own. And a labor not different from our own means this is the exactly what thing the poet is saying related to they in the lines they read. A labor not different from our own means if we are putting in hard labor with our hands and we are getting the result, the same is applicable to those people also. They also put in their hard labor. They also work hard and they are getting the result. It means same rules of life, same values are applicable to them. If it is applicable to them, then how we are different from each other? Okay, so it means that the poet is saying that there is not much difference between the people of the other countries, the people of the other territories, as well as between, as well as among us. Only we are creating these boundaries. Only we are creating these kind of differences. But actually what is there? There are not any kind of differences. It is only we people who have created. And if we, during peaceful life, during peace, if we are harvesting the rich yield, we are fed by, you can say, we are fed to our heart's content. Similarly, the effects of war are also faced by the people of those countries. And those effects are really very long to affect a person. It means it takes almost many generations to overcome the effects of these, you can say, sufferings. And it means that these rules are of course applicable to all. So we should not consider is that, you can say, the same thing. But actually what is there? That we are actually same in all kinds. Nature is also providing equal resources to all, and it is only we people who are discriminating. Clear this paragraph? Yes, is it clear? All right. So the next one is, let us remember. Remember, they have eyes like ours that wake or sleep, and strength that can be won by love. Yes. So now the poet is saying, remember. Remember, they have the same type of body structure as we people are having. Okay, they have eyes like us. If we are having eyes, the similar eyes they have, which follow the pattern of waking and sleeping. It means that we wake and sleep. And similarly, in this manner, these people also, they wake and sleep. Right? And strength can be won by, and strength that can be won by love. See in the next line, okay, the meaning, okay? And strength, and their strength, if they have strength, that can only be won by love. There is no other way to win strength. It is only love, okay, that can be, that can win this kind of strength. It means the strength can be won with love only. In every land is common life. In every land means in every land, wherever we go, to whichever part of the earth we go, there is just one type of life, similar type of life, and this type of life we are actually living. This is what the poet is saying. And that all can recognize and understand. That all can recognize and understand means that everyone can understand that there is not much difference between the life of our people and the people of the different countries. No, there is not any kind of difference. Actually, we people are quite similar. We are not different from each other. If we are not different from each other, then why we are creating these kind of differences? There is no need to create these kind of differences, right? Fine. That's clear, this paragraph, right? Okay, fine. So next, going further, let us remember whenever we are told to hate, it is ourselves. It is ourselves that we shall dispossess, betray, and condemn. Okay, so now what the poet is saying, okay, the poet is saying that when we are told, okay, when we are told to hate our brothers and sisters, okay, so when we are told means who are telling? Can anyone tell me that why we hate other people? Who told us to hate other people? Who tell us to hate other people? Yes. I asked you one question yesterday also, that when two soldiers are fighting, they have any kind of grudges with each other? No. They know each other? No. Then why they are fighting? For their countries? So when we are told to hate our brothers, when we are told to be against someone, or one community to be against another community, why? It is because that of the politicians who, because of their selfish motives, are telling us to hate our brothers. Actually, God has made us all equal. God has made us all one. And if we are creating differences, it is because of the reason that we are hating each other. It is not because of our selfish motives, but it is because someone else is telling us. And who's that telling us? It is nobody else than those politicians who, because of their selfish motives, because of their personal reasons to attain power, they are instigating, they are provoking the people to hate each other. So ultimately what is there, the poet is saying that it is only, let us remember when we are told to hate our brothers or to hate, it is not ourselves that ultimately who are doing this. It is the politicians who are telling this for their selfish motives to do that. And it is ourselves that we shall dispossess, betray, and condemn. So by doing this, it is only we people only, we are condemning ourselves. Condemn means to disapprove, dispossess, that we are not possessing these qualities. Okay, we are betraying ourselves. It is nobody else who is doing this. It is only because of this that these people, they are condemning us. Okay, these, and that we are condemning ourselves. Condemning means to disapprove anything completely, to completely disapprove anything. It is only we who are dispossessing, who are betraying, we are against all these. Okay? And remember, we who take arms against each other, and by doing so, okay, by doing so, we are forgetting the reality of our existence. We are forgetting the reality that we are actually one. If we are fighting with each other, we are betraying ourselves. We are different from ourselves. We are condemning ourselves, right? And ultimately, what is there? The poet is saying that ultimately we become against each other. It is nobody else, but it is only we who are doing all this, right? And the poet is always disapproving this kind of behavior, right? So poet is always disapproving this kind of behavior. The poet is saying that we should rise up from these kind of prejudices, differences, from this kind of narrow-mindedness, so that we can stand against all odds in life, and we must consider ourselves as one, because there must be the existence of oneness, and we are not different from each other. We are actually one. If we are actually one, God has made one, then it is only we when we are told to hate our brothers and sisters. It is nobody else, but somebody else who is taking the reins of our life in their hands. Reins means R-E-I-N-S. Okay, reins means, you know, the rope with which the horse is controlled. Okay, when the rider sits on it, it's reins. Similarly, the reins of our life, they are in the hands of other people. They are provoking us to fight our brothers and sisters. Why they are provoking us to fight with our brothers and sisters? Because we are following them. Why they are instructing us? Because of their selfish motives. And it is just because of their selfish motives that we are suffering a lot. And by doing so, we are not doing right with us. Actually, we are betraying ourselves. We are not looking at the actuality of the situation. We are not coming to know what actually the situation is. It is only we who are doing this wrong thing with us only, right? Clear this passage? Fine, right. So, it is the human earth that we defile. Now the poet is taking this poem to, to an environmental concern, right? See, by doing so, by wars, by use of arms, ammunition, okay, by using weapons. So what is happening? It is earth that we defile. Defile means destroy. It is our earth. Okay, we are doing nothing. We are destroying our planet. Okay, we are defiling our planet. Okay, our hells of fire. Our hells of fire. Hells of fire means what is this? When nuclear weapons or arms and ammunition, they are used, lot of destruction is produced, fire is produced. And what is this? This is symbolic of hell. Hell of fire, hells of fire. Hells of fire means in these, you can say fires, many lives are burnt and it is not less than a hell. Comparison is fair. Hells of fire metaphor, okay? And ultimately, and dust outrage the innocence. And dust means because of this lot of fire is produced, because of the use of nuclear weapons and all. Because of this, because as lot of fire and dust is produced, smoke is produced. Okay, dust here also refers to smoke. Dust, fire and smoke is produced. And ultimately, they outrage means they kill. They kill or they take away the innocence from the face of the earth. The innocence, which is actually, you can say, a part of human life. It is taken away from here. Okay, which means that human life, which is otherwise considered to be innocent, it is no longer innocent. Okay, as it is no longer innocent, it is creating a lot of difference in the lives of people. People, they suffer a lot. People, they face a lot of problems. And ultimately, like hells of fire and lot of dust and smoke is produced. And ultimately, their life is definitely affected because of all. Right? So the next line is, of air that is everywhere our own. Why we forget this thing that our air and their air is not different? Everywhere our air is same means that we cannot demarcate natural resources. We cannot say that this is our air and this is the air of other country. Actually, what is there? What is there? That we are sharing the same atmosphere. We are under the same blanket of atmosphere. We are under the same, you can say, the same protection of the nature. Then why we are separating ourselves? We are forgetting this reality. We are forgetting this fact that we are not separate from each other. We shall never be able to separate our, you can say, we shall never be able to separate ourselves from others. And this is actually the poet is describing us that we should not be able to separate ourselves from others. We are actually part of this earth. We are same, and it is because of this reason that we should live a life of its own type without demarcating ourselves into categories, never categorizing yourself, never separating yourself, never prioritizing yourself, but consider the uniformity of life on this earth, that actually we are same. We are not different from each other, right? It's clear now? It's clear? Right. And remember, no men are foreign and no countries strange. Now the poet is again delivering us the fact that we should not forget this thing that no countries are strange and no men are foreign. Actually, we of course are same and we are living a life of sameness, and we should never forget this thing that we are not different from each other. We are actually same. And why we human beings are forgetting these things that we are not different from, that we are not different. And actually, it is only we people who have created these kind of differences. We should not forget this, right? We should not forget this kind of thing that we are not demarcated. We are not separated from each other. We are one and we should live a life of oneness. So, right? Okay, so this is all about the point, no men are foreign. And ultimately, if you have any doubt, now you can clear the doubts with me. If you have any problem in any, you can say line, just go through it at once. I'm giving you 2 to 3 minutes and you can ask me the doubts.